गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ प्रिया, योर साइंस टीचर. इन दिस वीडियो आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू द चैप्टर नंबर 14 ऑफ योर टेक्स्ट बुक, दैट इज़ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट एंड इट्स इफेक्ट्स. इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रिकल कॉम्पोनेंट्स, द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट, देयर सिम्बल्स एंड द हीटिंग इफेक्ट ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट एंड द मैग्नेटिक इफेक्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट एंड देयर एप्लीकेशंस ऑन आर डेली लाइफ. So let us understand these one by one. First of all, what is electric current? Any flow of charge through a wire or through any object is known as the electric current. So for the flow of electric current, we need different types of electrical components that facilitate the flow of an electric current. So let us understand these components one by one. These are some electrical components that are used while flowing of an electric current. First is the electric cell. This is the diagram of an electric cell and this is the symbol of an electric cell. The symbol of an electric cell is represented as a longer line and a shorter line. The longer line is generally the positive terminal and the shorter line is the negative terminal. This means that an electric cell has two terminals, that is a positive terminal and a negative terminal. The second electrical component is the electric bulb. This is the symbol of an electric bulb. The next electrical component is the switch. So the condition of switch is of two types, that is in a closed circuit the switch is in on position and in a open circuit the switch is in off position. So this is the symbol of the switch in off position and this is the symbol of the on position. The next electrical component is a battery. Battery is simply, it is the combination of two or more cells. And as you can see in the diagram, this is the symbol of the battery. This is the positive terminal and this is the negative terminal. The last electrical component is simply a wire. It is simply indicated by a line. So this is the symbol of a wire. So these are some important electrical components that are used in a flow of current. First of all, what is an electric cell? As I told you, that electric cell, it has a positive terminal and it has a negative terminal. The symbol of an electric cell is a longer line and a shorter line. The longer line is the positive terminal and the shorter line is the negative terminal. The battery, it is the combination of two or more cells like this. So as you can see in the diagram, in a battery, the positive terminal of one cell is connected to the negative terminal of another cell. So devices like torches, transistors, toys, TV remote, they control the use of the. So this diagram represents the combination of cell which is called a battery. So let us understand the electric circuit, a simple electric circuit. So as you can see in the diagram, these both are diagram of a simple electric circuit. In a simple electric circuit, it is made up of a cell, an electric bulb, a switch and a wire. The bulb glows only when the switch is in on position and the circuit is closed. ठीक है, जैसा कि आप closed circuit में देख सकते हैं कि closed circuit में switch अगर दोनों end से connected है, ठीक है, तभी इसमें करंट फ्लो करेगा और तभी जो है बल्ब ग्लो होगा. इन कंट्रास्ट अगर हम ओपन इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किट की बात करें, ओपन इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किट में जो यहाँ से स्विच है, जो ये ब्रेक हो चुका है, ठीक है, अगर स्विच ब्रेक हो चुका है, जो करंट का फ्लो है वो रेजिस्ट हो चुका है, तो जिसकी वजह से करंट फ्लो नहीं करेगा एंड दी बल्ब विल नॉट ग्लो. सो दिस इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन एन क्लोज इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किट एंड एन ओपन इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किट. Always remember that bulb glows only when the switch is on position and the current flows only when the switch is on position. In contrast, the bulb will not glow when the switch is in off position and the current will not flow in a circuit. Next, let us understand the heating effect of electric current. So, what is the heating effect of electric current? We can understand this by performing an activity. First of all, when electric current flows through a wire, the wire gets heated because of some resistance. So this is called the heating effect of electric current. To understand this, we can perform an activity that make an electric circuit as shown in the figure. Take a 10 cm long nichrome wire and tie it between the two nails. This wire switch on the current and after few seconds you can touch the wire, you can observe that the wire feels hot because of the heating effect of this flow of electric current. Then switch off the current and after few seconds touch the wire again. इट डज नॉट फील हॉट. दिस शोज दैट व्हेन इलेक्ट्रिक करंट फ्लोज थ्रू अ वायर इट गेट्स हीटेड. ठीक है, जब इलेक्ट्रिक करंट एक वायर के थ्रू फ्लो करता है तो उसके अंदर कुछ रेजिस्टेंस पार्टिकल्स होते हैं जो रेजिस्टेंस प्रोवाइड करते हैं, जो उसके फ्लो को अपोज करते हैं. ठीक है, जो इलेक्ट्रिक करंट के फ्लो को अपोज करते हैं, सो दिस इज नोन एज रेजिस्टेंस. उस रेजिस्टेंस की वजह से जो हीटिंग होती है दैट इज नोन एज द हीटिंग इफेक्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट. सो व्हेन एन इलेक्ट्रिक करंट फ्लोज थ्रू अ वायर द वायर गेट्स हीटेड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस हीटिंग इफेक्ट. The applications of the heating effect are that heating effect of electric current is used in various electrical appliances. For example, electric heater, together an electric iron, electric room heater, immersion heater, electric kettle, hair dryer, etc. All these appliances have a coil of wire called an element. This coil gets heated when the electric current flows through this element. It becomes hot and gives out the heat. So this is the heating effect of electric current which is used in various types of electrical appliances. The amount of heat that is produced in an electrical appliance because of the heating effect, it depends upon various types of factors. For example, material. If it is a conductor, then the amount of current flows is much larger than as compared to the insulator. It depends on the length. If the length of the wire is more, then the heating effect will be more. The third factor is the thickness. If the thickness or the area of the wire is more, then the heating effect of electric current will decrease, or vice versa. So these are some factors on which the heating effect of electric current depends. Next is the example of electric fuse. Electric fuse is basically based on the principle of the heating effect of electric current. Electric fuse is a safety device which is used in various electrical circuits, which protects the electrical circuits and appliances to prevent the fire. In case of large electric current flow or in case of large amount of heating, the electrical fuse is used in all the electric circuits in buildings and in various types of places. So electric fuse basically has a wire which melts quickly and they break the circuit when large amount of electric current flows through an appliance. In case of electric transformers, the electric fuses are fitted in between these two transformers, because in the case of high electric current, the electric fuse, it melts and it breaks the circuit so that no further electric current flows through the circuit. This prevents the fire. So this is the example of an heating effect of electric current. The next is the very important, that is magnetic effect of electric current. This we can understand with the help of an activity. So what is magnetic effect? When electric current flows through a wire, through a coil, through a conductor, or through an insulating wire, it behaves like a magnet. So this is called the magnetic effect of electric current. We can understand this with the help of an activity. Take the cardboard and tray from a matchbox, wind an electric wire a few times around the cardboard tray like a coil. So place a small compass needle inside this matchbox tray and connect the free ends of the wire that you have coiled around the cardboard tray to the electric cell and that of the switch. When the switch is on position and the compass needle deflects because the current flows through the electric circuit, which generates the magnetic effect around the coil which you have wind around your cardboard box. So when the switch is off, the compass needle comes back to its original position, because the compass needle, it shows response only to the magnetism. So this shows that when the electric current flows through a wire, it behaves like a magnet. So this is the magnetic effect of electric current. The next is an example of an electromagnet. Electromagnet, it is also basically based on the magnetic effect of electric current. First of all, what is the electromagnet? When an electric current is passed through a coil of an insulated wire which is wound around a piece of iron, it becomes a magnet. Such type of magnet is known as electromagnet. We can perform an activity to understand this electromagnet. Wind a piece of an insulated wire around an iron nail in the form of a coil. Then connect the free ends of the wire to the battery and the switch to make a full electric circuit. Now place some pins near the nail. You can place some iron pins or you can iron nails और यू कैन यूज सम सेफ्टी पिंस टू प्लेस नियर दी रेल. वेन एन इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इज पास्ड थ्रू दिस सर्किट द आयरन नेल इट बिकम्स अ मैग्नेट बिकॉज द विद करंट फ्लोज थ्रू अ कॉइल इट जनरेट्स अ मैग्नेटिज्म अराउंड दिस आयरन नेल एंड इट अट्रैक्ट्स द आयरन नेल्स और द पिंस दैट आर प्लेस्ड नियर द आयरन नेल एंड वेन इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इज स्विच्ड ऑफ द नेल इट लूजेज इट्स मैग्नेटिज्म. सो दिस शोज दैट देन आयरन नेल इट बिहेव्स लाइक अ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेट बिकॉज इट जनरेट्स एन मैग्नेटिज्म अंडर द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रिक करंट. So this is an example of an electromagnet. Next is the application of an electromagnet. An electric bell. Electric bell is basically based on the principle of an electromagnet. And firstly, we'll understand the structure of an electric bell and then we will understand its working. First, the electric bell, it has a coil of wire which is wrapped around a piece of iron that has two poles, that is north pole and south pole. It behaves like an electromagnet. An iron strip with a hammer is kept close to the electromagnet. There is a contact screw near the iron strip. When this iron strip, it comes in contact with the screw, the current flows through the coil and it behaves like an electromagnet. It pulls the iron strip upwards and the hammer at the end of the strip, it strikes the gong of the bell and it produces sound. Thus the bell rings. And when the electromagnets, it pull the iron strip, it comes back to its original position, which breaks the circuit and this further this process repeats and the bell rings. So this is the working of an electric bell. I hope you have understood this chapter very well. The applications, the heating effect of electric current and the magnetic effect of electric current and their applications, these are very important topics. You should focus on these topics and if you have any doubt, you can contact me anytime. Thank you.